It is a panoramic view, and I've got the other way around as well. I can't imagine living in an ordinary street now. It'd be too dark, too closed in. I'd absolutely hate it.
This is my house here. I lived here for 40 years now, isn't it, 80? And this is our kitchen. You can see they're not... They're not very big, but we've had them a few years back now. My mum always said she never regretted coming here because it saved us a lot on bus fares. Her work was just down the road in the morning. Shops were everywhere, town and also Bedminster. And we got to meet quite a lot of nice people living here. So we've been here ever since. That was April 1980.
Because it's like a village, I suppose. And when you think about it, Redcliffe is really an island. Because you can't get to Redcliffe without crossing a bridge at some stage. So I suppose we're islanders in a way. I mean, we were very snooty. We wouldn't want to be classed with people from Bedminster at one time. We came from Redcliffe, not Benny. So there was just that little bit, but that's all gone now. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think that applies anymore.
We've got big community room, so we can make our food and stay the night and just chat. We can sing along together and dance and do our traditional dance.
You know, well, we all arrange like to go out on a particular day, we all chip in and everything, and it's just how you get close. It's like a bonding session, you know? So we all go out, you know, Weston, Weymouth, you know, wherever, and have a nice laugh.
It's a bit like Redcliffe on tour.
Yeah.
I mean, it was illegal, according to the council, to have a barbecue on a veranda. But we used to have a little charcoal one on a stand, no damage or anything. And we used to have little parties, so you could cook the most on the barbecues, you know. I had hanging baskets on the wall outside. Council said to take it down because it was a health risk. So that broke the community up, really, you know.
Certain days of the week, you can smell all the food's being cooked for the week. And yes, and you do hear in the lift all different languages that you don't understand. But then I always speak to all the children and they always answer me.
It has changed over the years. For example, they had a massive tenant group then. Of course, as it changed over and more of the ethnic groups came in, they had their own little groups and so on. So we got smaller, but we still managed to keep it going.
The community that live here now, 95% of them don't want to communicate or integrate with us. And you try to have a conversation with them and it's non-existent. And that's what is frustrating.
There's a lot of racism going on, and people keep saying to Somalian people, so you have to go back home and go back to where you come from. Especially my son, they racist him a lot. And saying, you got Ebola. Even children said, you can't play with us because you come from Africa, you got Ebola. And he was born in St. Michael Hospital in Bristol.
How would you describe life?
You need to adjust to it. It's gonna take a while to adjust to. It's easy for someone who's lived in blocks all their lives, but for someone to come from having a back garden and having their own, a lot of space, it's hard. Rooms are a lot smaller and yeah. So crammed.
Well, like I said, I've been here 15 years, and especially on my landing, because I've known them so long, in some ways we have each other's backs, you know, all the kids play together, and if your kid's not on the landing, you just text your mate, you know they're along two doors down. But it is all right living here.
You're never short on company. There's always someone there to talk to, someone's around to, if you need to vent or you want to go down to the park, or there's always someone there. Helpful and handy.
I'd rather live somewhere quieter than here, because people are now really crowded, a lot crowded, and that racism, especially with that issue, just want me to move and to live somewhere quieter and safer.
I have got a beautiful masonette, but if I could move it somewhere else in Bristol, I would do it tomorrow.
I did go over the show flats there, and apparently they're selling for £1 million plus. so I don't think I'll be moving.
Of course, now you've got a Michelin star restaurant around the corner.
Oh, yeah, well, that's well out of most of our league gear. Yeah. We still go to the Bedminster cafes and things, most of us.